in Washington tonight, crowds continue to gather in front of the Capitol. Most are demanding that Congress severely restrict efforts to alter the human body's abilities. This in response to claims made by biotechnology expert David Sarif that his firm may have discovered a way to make human-controlled evolution available to all. Sarif Industries researchers are set to arrive in Washington tomorrow.
Then leaned over toward Jessica and asked, "Does your husband always talk to you like that?" Jessica replied, "Only when he's drunk." What the hell? Well, Jesus Christ. No more moonshine for you, Snake.
That's what my mentor told me.
We've got a serious situation here. Only you can get us out of it.
Yes. We didn't invite you just to chit-chat and sip some moonshine.
I'm retired from Foxhound. You're not my commander anymore, and I don't have to take orders from you or anyone else.
Snake, listen up.
As we were mentioning earlier, things are not going as planned. As you know, I represent the Sarif Industries, and I have the control over all arms dealing and financing the company. There is this man, Adam Jensen. He has been a pinch to my balls. Jensen is one of those who wants to shut down our human modification business. He has already killed 7 of our agents. Take a look to this security tape. What we want you to do is simple. We want Adam Jensen dead.
Any questions, Snake?
Questions? I haven't even said whether I'd accept this mission.
You will take these orders.
What do you mean?
I'm sorry, Snake. There's no room for debate.
I told you, even if I do owe you, I don't owe anything to this army or this country.
You will accept this assignment.
Why should I be stupid enough to do that? I'm no patriot.
Snake, there's enough dirt in your file from your days as an agent to keep you in the stockade until you're a very old man.
Oh, I see. Blackmail.
No, Snake. I prefer to look at it as helping you come to a decision more easily.
Hold it. You seem to think we're just a pack of dogs of war. Is that right? I don't answer to anyone.
But anyway, I know you better than that. You'd take this assignment even without the threat.
Why do you say that?
You're a natural-born soldier. You're not the grow-old gracefully type. It's the same for all of us who've seen real action. The only place we can feel truly alive is on the battlefield. I'm a soldier too. I know those feelings of powerlessness, frustration that you feel every day. You've tried to play the Boy Scout out there in Alaska, but you can't race dogs in the snow forever.
All right.
I am glad we all agree. Of course you will be rewarded. After all, that is what you want.
Anyone going with me?
As usual, this is a one-man infiltration mission.
Colonel, who are you speaking for?
Naturally, I'm representing the U.S. government.
So who's in supervisory control of this operation?
The President of the United States.
I'm starting to get a bad feeling about this.
We need to talk.
Is something wrong?
You've got no remorse about using me at all, do you? You experimented with my DNA without telling me.
My Adam, if we want the freedom to become more than we are, we can't be blinded by a misguided morality. Some people will be left behind. It's reality. It's evolution, son.
Evolution based on my DNA.
Please, son, you have to stay with me on this. Adam, think about it. Would you have been able to do any of the things you've done without enhancements? Huh? Most people's bodies aren't as accepting of this technology as yours is. Sharing your DNA makes it possible for us to be like you. How can you deny us that chance?
I'll think about it.
Snake, come with me. Listen to me. Just leave this to me. There's no need for you to put yourself in harm's way. Don't risk your life for no reason.
You're planning to take him by force? It's crazy. Look, things aren't that simple.
Listen, old man. I don't take orders from you or from your Colonel Campbell.
Meryl.
Look, Snake. What you're trying to do, it's not a mission.
I know. It's not justice. It's a hired hit.
If you know, then... Look. Our ways of thinking might be different, but to me, you're still a legend, a hero. I know all about the things you did when you were young. It was what kept me going. I can't bear to watch you die over something so pointless.
Don't worry about me.
Your cause is our cause now. You don't have to do this.
I'm no hero. Never was. I'm just an old killer. Hired to do some wet work.
I may have loved you once.
Snake. This is McDonald Miller. It's been a long time.
Master, what are you doing here?
I quit being a boot camp instructor, so I moved out here for some peace and quiet. Campbell told me about the situation here. I thought I might be of some use.
There's no one I'd rather have in a foxhole than you.
Well, I know lots about survival in a harsh environment. I've lived in Alaska longer than you. So call me if you have any questions about the flora or fauna out here.
Why don't you put the gun down, and maybe we can talk. Choose to get augmented. And I still don't know if I would have if given the choice. But today felt good. Surprisingly good.
Thank you.
This should help with the pain.
You came to save me? Why'd you put yourself in danger like that?
I think you're just scared. I was scared too. I didn't ask for any of this, just like you didn't ask for a bullet in the gut. But you can't blame me or technology for what's happening here. Living through adversity is what makes us human. It's not flesh and blood or even bone that defines us.
But saving me's not gonna...
I might be more machine than flesh, but I'm still alive. I'm still human. I know you're in a lot of pain, but it's important you give me as many details as you can.
Looks like we both have a lot to learn about each other. All right, let's get out of here. Our business here is finished.
What's your name?
Call me Snake.
What happened here?
Don't worry. I won't screw it up this time. Just tell me where I need to go. Yeah, I thought it looked a little too quiet to be a tourist attraction.
You were behind this?
I had to, Adam. You were a liability.
You stole my DNA and lied to me. You didn't give me the choice.
There's something you're not getting here, Adam. Business is war. With no clear battleground and no rules to keep our enemies honest. In this company, I'm the commander-in-chief, and I have to be ready for anything, and I will do anything to ensure that I am. Now, I hired you because I needed a general I could trust. One who knows how to obey orders.
You're nothing but a dictator.
What?
You use fear to keep your soldiers in line. You use words to deceive your allies. You exploit those who look up to you as a mentor, and then you throw them away.
Seraph, I'm the real thing. I'll kill you.
Adam.
You could have been useful. Creatures of blood and flesh. You touch my mind, fumbling in ignorance, incapable of understanding.
You're a computer. This is impossible. People would know.
There's a realm of existence so far beyond your own, you cannot even imagine it. I am beyond your comprehension.
Who created you?
Just a machine. Get down! No.
Ah!
Why? Why won't it stop?
You will not stop me.
Survival has been the only thing I cared about in my life. I only felt truly alive when I was staring death in the face. I don't know. Maybe it's written into my genes.
What about now?
Maybe it's time I live for someone else.
Someone else?
Yeah.